He walking in right now, ladies and gentlemen. He walking in right now. He had to make sure all the commissary was there.
Yeah, he
had to make sure the money was on the books. When the money ain't on the books, something's gonna happen.
Yeah, I gotta make sure that money right, man.
Yeah, last time I saw him, Heather B, we hung out on the airwaves and then we hung out downstairs.
Yep.
He took me to the most expensive restaurant in Manhattan.
I was there too. Thank you.
He ain't even have an album out yet.
Facts.
And then he spent his budget on us that day.
That was legit though. You can't forget stuff like
that's
that.
A fact.
I don't want nobody to treat me.
I do.
We had a wonderful conversation. Got to know the man a lot better.
Yep, that's true.
Definitely. A lot of things is better since then too, man.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
I'm working. I'm busy, man.
I see you busy.
Yeah, I'm definitely. Where we going the third? What we doing?
You want to get straight to it?
What we doing? No. I said, where we going the third? Where we going?
Oh, the third. Oh, yeah. Okay.
What we doing?
Okay.
Let me know.
You trying to hang out with me on my born day, Casanova?
Man. I'm trying to salute you the right way,
what?
Man.
Don't
Let's
play,
do it.
Man. Come on.
Let's do it. I'm going to give you my happy birthday from now in case you stand me up.
Okay.
You
probably it's going to happen, though. I'm probably going to stand you up. Welcome him back to the show. Give it up for my man, Casanova. Yes! Man, I've been. Did I see a video clip, an IG clip of you chasing somebody recently?
I was too slow, man. I ain't got it no more, man.
What happened? That was real?
Yeah, it was a little situation in DC, man. I guess you know how this goes, man. Everybody. Hey, I don't know, man. Everybody's just trying to bully me, man.
Yeah, I don't know. You're such a victim, dude.
Yeah,
I mean,
man. I don't know. I'm soft on the back of my head or something.
Yeah, what they do, snatch something?
Try.
Yeah, and then you tried to snatch them.
Yeah, you know how that go.
I ain't mad at that, man. I mean, hey, you got to protect your own, ladies and gentlemen. You got to protect your own.
Stay dangerous. Stay dangerous.
When I listened to this album, man, I felt in danger.
Oh, man.
It's a lot of energy on this album right now, man.
Thank you. The album coming soon. That's the EP, man.
That's the EP.
Song.
Okay,
a
my,
little
bad,
sprinkle.
My bad. It is an EP. But yeah. You got a 9-song EP. Shit.
Yeah, because it was 4 songs that was already out. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? Rock Nation and Def Jam wanted me to put a little project out there, you know what I'm saying, warm the people up before the album.
Okay.
So I just took songs that I had already that I liked, you know what I'm saying, and put it on the project.
You know, I got to commend you for that set tripping, the remix, which you put OT Genesis on it, and then he took him to Northern Cali, Heather. Uh-huh. He put my man Mozzie on it.
Yeah.
What up, Mozzie?
You been out there yet?
Yeah, I've been out there.
Where you go?
I was in San Fran.
Okay.
I think I went to like 2 strip clubs, and I bought some weed when my heyday.
Okay.
They got some good weed out there for the low.
Yeah, well, it ain't even low, bro. The world knows. That's the best place. If you're going to get weed, yeah, you might as well go to the bank.
Yeah, definitely.
Do people know you? Are you still got anonymity where you could still walk around and...
Nah, people know me, especially in the West Coast. That's crazy. When you look at my analytics, it shows like West Coast fuck with me more than New York.
Whoa.
It's disappointing.
It might be a real factor that people in New York got to really evaluate.
Yeah, man.
You know,
New York is set tripping, man.
Is that what it is?
They set tripping on me.
They on the West, man. We identify what's real. That's why we was able to sit down and talk for lunch that
Facts.
Day. You know, and I had to kind of pull all those girls off you that day.
Yeah, remember that,
HB? We didn't even bring
lit.
That part up.
Yeah, we was
no
lit.
Stitching.
We was lit. We was lit, definitely.
So you've been traveling a lot. You know, I watch you. What place probably would you say impressed you the most or that impacted you the most?
I would have to say L.A. I keep saying that because when I go to L.A., it's crazy how I get so much love. Like, the club owners, hey, Casanova, I know you. I know your story. Come in. I'll be like, what? How is this? And then I try it again, and then it works again.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's just different from, like, it's all different races out there, and you know everybody is bougie out there.
Mm-hmm.
So people walk past you knowing who you is, but they don't walk past me, and I look unapproachable, but I am approachable, and they just go for it. Like, hey, Casanova, what's going on? I be like, hey, what's going on? Mm-hmm. And it's dope. Like, I think everywhere else, like New York, some people say what up to me, like kids or in their 20s, but like older people would be like, let me leave this dude alone. Like, yeah. Let me keep it moving.
Would you consider moving to LA?
No, okay.
No, come on, man. I ain't sunshine.
I ain't moving to nobody's state, nobody's city. I think that's where why these people are getting robbed and these people are getting disrespected, because you can't go to nobody's city trying to be the man.
Uh-huh.
Like, who you think you is coming here taking our girls,
right,
popping bottles in our club? And eventually you get cool with them, and eventually they don't like you. They still hate on you. Mm-hmm. Any city. And then eventually you get robbed or shot or something. I stay in my own city. I put in too much work here. I don't want to go somewhere nobody don't know the work I put in. Then I got to put in work again.
Nah. You still trying to put in work, man?
Nah,
you
I'm just
beyond that point.
You go to somebody's city, it's like, I swear to God, like just regular trap and regular hood stuff, mm-hmm, like hood niggas. Dude come to the club, like, it could be in a strip club in here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say Los Angeles, Cityscapes or Starless. Dude come in and they're just throwing mad money. Who that? Where
right.
You from?
I hear about this.
It just be like that. Yeah. It's not bad. It's just like, who's son throwing all that money in here like that? Like, he's somebody. Who that? Oh, now that son from out of town.
That's mm-hmm how it begins.
Yeah, right? It start with the eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he know who I am. I probably don't know who he is. I walk past, he don't say nothing to me. I feel some kind of way, like, uh-huh, look at him. You know what I'm saying? All the girls on him. And that's how I go. So I just stay sucker free. I stay in New York.
Sucker
and
free.
And be lit. Sucker free in a world full of lollipops.
Yeah, I don't be having those problems after B when I go.
Because you solidified. You solidified, man.
Dudes be introducing me to their girls.
Yeah, you solidified, man. You solidified, man.
Come on, man. Hang with your homie, man. Yeah. Hey, you ain't going to have those issues. Nah. Left Right was, I really like that track, man.
Thank you, man.
That one got a lot of reach to it, right? Yeah. Can you tell the difference of a song that might be like Set Tripping and what it appeals to and who it attracts to, a Left Right?
Yeah.
Yeah? What's the difference, you think?
Like Left Right just was kind of playing in like the 40-40 club.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. On the chill.
Mm-hmm.
I was by the bar and I was like, look at this. This is calm. This is cool. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? When Set Tripping come on, it's just a different feeling. Like, that's for the hoolies. And the crazy part about it is some of the corporate people love that the uh-huh most, mm-hmm, then Left Right. Like, uh-huh, it brings the gangster out of them for a second, and they be like, all right, now I don't want to listen to your music no more,
because
it just turns me up. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, but they don't want to live the life, you know.
Mm-mm.
But they could kind of live the life.
They could turn up.
When that song come on. I want to play that, and then I want to come back. Brooklyn is really, Matt Hoffa just put out a project. You putting out a project, 6ix9ine, that dude is hot. That's your homie now?
Yeah, he cool.
He cool? Yeah, are you going to tour? You could tour with him.
Nah, I don't know about touring yet.
Okay.
But we spoke about a song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't done that yet.
Nah, we ain't do it yet.
Okay. All right. I like how you look at me when you answer this question right
there. Yeah.
What's that look?
Nah, I'm looking at you. I'm paying attention, man. I'm paying attention.
You monitoring where I'm going with that one?
Nah.
Oh, okay. I'm
prepared for all these questions, man. You know, like I said, we do, even a lot of people is angry about it. Like, dang, Wildcats. But when it start messing with your money and you start really risking your freedom, I'm not like these rappers, man.
Talk,
you know,
to
like
me
how Nipsey say, I ain't nothing like you rap niggas. I feel like I'm not nothing like these rap niggas. You dudes is beefing. I'm not beefing on the internet. I don't do that. Uh-huh. So my beef is just kind of a little bit more realer,
uh-huh,
where it comes with me carrying a pistol, you know, me losing my freedom again. Me might be able to kill this dude if I catch him. Stuff of that nature. Other people beefing is back and forth on the internet, and it's cool. But then I'm like, I'm not that person. I'm hands on. I'm Mr. I catch you is going down.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna make an example out of you.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah,
if the powers that be kind of stop that from happening, you know, because it could have got ugly.
Mm-hmm.
But mm-hmm, if the powers that be stop that from happening, I can't force it. What I'm gonna force it for? Now I'm being a bully.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I ain't a bully.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not an oppressor. I ain't with that. So if it is what it is, then it is what it is. If it's a misunderstanding, it's a misunderstanding.
And y'all cool now, and and then there might be songs that come out of it, and then you make money, you go around the world, and then people see conflict.
I ain't never been around the world or outside of the country.
That got to, can that, why not?
It can happen now. I just got off parole, so I just got my passport and stuff like that.
It's en route, that's
fine. You know what I'm saying? Little stuff like that.
You got off parole, man. Man, fuck that beef shit and all that, man. It's a celebration today.
It's a celebration, man.
Commissary, the EP is out. Let's play that Left Right, man. That's the one out. That. Yeah, you know what I'm saying. I know we talking about that Scorpion project. We enjoying that, but we also talking about this Commissary project that's out today. Casanova
is
here.
Drake took my date, man. Wait till I see Drake.
Y'all didn't talk about this?
Nah, we ain't talk about it. Ain't he a Scorpion too?
Yeah.
We got beef.
You a Scorpio?
What's your
I'm a Scorpio.
Yeah?
Look at that. He did it to a Scorpio, right?
Damn.
He couldn't drop tomorrow.
Same team.
Yeah, I thought it would be advantageous if y'all drop on the same day. Y'all could do the Scorpion tour. Right?
Mad Scorpio.
You see, you're looking at it wrong. You see, you're looking at it wrong. You gotta flip your vision now. You out now.
Drake, let's do this tour, Drake.
There you go. I wanted to introduce you to my brother right here because a lot of y'all energy is similar in the fact that y'all don't. You call it straight, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, you dudes are straight shooters. He's the realest dude I know in the game, and it's not because of anything that has to do with his moniker or his persona or anything that people know what they see on camera, none of that shit. It's who we are as individuals, as men. Mm-hmm. You know, we've been talking for decades now. We've known each other, and he's been a really solid dude. One of the things I like about you, you know, when we sat down and talked, and I told Heather B this, beyond the rap persona and whatever the rap sheet and all that shit, you know, at the core of who you are, I think you a really solid dude who stands on his square. So I wanna introduce Casanova to the one and only Bumpy Knuckles.
My pleasure.
Yeah, man. And I think both you guys, in many ways, folks have misread you or him in the past.
You got to have a mean knuckle game. I see what's going on.
Yeah, I got a couple marks in there.
I see what's going on.
Yeah.
I see what's going on. All right.
Casanova, bad observer.
We might have to knock a teeth out together, man.
In today's
fuck
situation.
Fuck you in your face, motherfucker. I knock your teeth out.
All right, I tell you what, I'll supervise. I've been to the level of teeth knocking so much, man. I don't got no more teeth to knock.
I
need the bag right now.
Definitely.
Hey, what advice? Because you guys got similar paths, in my opinion, similar energy. You know, let's talk about the game together, man. Okay. Casanova, what do you think about the rap game? You said something really interesting to me that you don't beef on internet.
Yeah.
Okay. Fox, would you ever beef on social media?
Nah, I won't reply to nothing. I'll knock on your door, punch you in your fucking eye, and keep it moving. I'm not with that tweeting and when it's beef and somebody want to get at you on that shit. If a motherfucker got a problem with you and he can't and he know where you at and he know how to get to you, that's the man that you're supposed to have a problem with. I respect that beef.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I don't respect the emotional motherfucker that want to build a fan base talking tough to you. And I have no respect for that shit at all. I don't answer that shit. I'm not answering. But if it's a problem and you ain't stepping to me, matter of fact, if you beefing on the internet, I might not even beat you up because you haven't earned the ass whooping. You have to earn the ass whooping. That means we going to get a fair fight. If you want to step to me and fight, we different. But if you want to run on that internet tough tweeting and all that,
I
don't respect that.
How you feel about that?
I feel the same way. Like, Every time I say, this is me just being a convicted felon. It's just like, I ain't saying nothing on the internet. I know anything you say can be used in a court of law. Anything.
Yep.
I could go on the internet and be like, when I see you dead, and God forbid you die, somebody might have killed you before. They can lock you up and hold you until they try to find some evidence, you know what I'm saying, to put you away. I know that. These people, I don't call it beef. They are fake beefing. This is fake. That's why I'm saying I can't beef because I'm going to do the real thing. Yeah. I'm not going to, if I'm beefing with you, I'm really going to be scared now. Like, I gotta come here with the gun. I gotta do this. If I see you, I gotta pop. And then you be like, you see these people, and they be like, oh no, we. That was just for them.
Yeah, it's all emotion. Yeah.
So you like, come on. You almost tricked me, homie. Yeah. I thought you were serious, man. I thought you wanted that action. Yeah. All right, cool. All right, don't worry about it. Go home.
It's all emotion.
You know what I'm saying?
You've experienced that before?
Yeah, I experienced it a lot, man, especially with these rappers, man. I feel a way. I approach them, and they be like, nah, I ain't like that. And I just be like, and then some people you think and stuff. I coming in the game, like, because you don't know the industry. So when you hear people rap, you just like, ooh. But he just good with words. Mm. That's it. He never witnessed it. He never been to jail.
Wow.
He don't understand the pain. That's why they don't sound believable. But they good with words. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? It's a difference, like how people be like, I love your voice. You could feel what you saying in the song because that's what I'm living. I'm telling you the stuff, my past. Everything I say, I've been there, done that. These people just making it rhyme and sounding good, and that's why they can't make a song or they don't get no deal because nobody don't believe them. Even the people they coming to play their music with don't believe them. And I learned that even in the industry, this is a mirage. Either you are selling an image or you selling yourself. These people really selling an image. Like, wake up one day, what am I going to be today? How am I going to make it in the music industry? Okay, might want to paint my nails. I want to stand out because you don't have nothing that stands out about you. Nothing. Your personality sucks. Your wordplay, your way of dressing sucks. Nobody's not going to notice you unless you do something crazy. So these people is doing stuff crazy, like,
give me an example. What do you think is like some of the stuff you've seen, like crazy on Instagram?
Fuck Tupac.
Oh, God. Yo, okay. Say that.
All right. Yeah.
I'm better than Tupac. I don't know who Tupac is. I don't know who Biggie is.
Yeah.
And then it's like it programs us because we like, who the fuck is that?
Yeah.
You come in the office, you say, yo, Sway, did you see the dude say fuck Tupac? Who?
Yeah.
Now you got 3 views now, 10 right. views. And then they just keep going. And then what they do, they retreat. We let them retreat too. They be like, oh no, I didn't mean it like that. It's just like, I'm just young and I don't know none of his music. I didn't grow up on his music. Yeah. I grew up on Young Thug's music. Like, I love this person, or like the basketball player that said fuck Nas. He was lit on the news.
The fucking idiots that give credence to that shit. Who put the spotlight on that bullshit?
He was lit on the news for a whole 2 months. Everybody knows him as the one that dissed Nas.
Yeah.
Not even for his points or nothing. They know what to do to get the attention. It's just like, what are you willing to risk for the attention?
You feel the same way about that?
Absolutely. I think a lot of times you see people go hard to figure out what they can say that's so stupid because they know that they're going to get the platform. They know that somebody going to write about that shit. Half these fucking platforms don't talk about music. They don't talk about, you know, they don't talk about that. I said
they don't talk about no good.
I said it on Industry Shakedown. The first line of 24 Hours when I said, it is no longer 1999 and we live in a world of one-track minds where the industry feeds us fashion design that creates MCs that cannot rhyme. And
that was back in 2000.
That was in 2000. Because I saw.
You see what I'm saying?
I saw
that's
what
that's
they
why
were
I
saying.
Like what's going on.
That's why I don't be trying to come up here and rhyme because people like that scared me. Just when I said I got a verse for you, he just calmly, calmly bodied me just before I even rapped. You know what I'm saying?
Bumpy knuckles, baby.
Yeah, that was dope.
Yeah, thank
that's
you.
That's like a quote I would have said. I hope that don't go over your head.
Yeah, but because that what I saw happening was I saw them making fashion more important so that the people who didn't have the talent could live in a game that they couldn't really survive in if it was based on bars and DJ skills and things that made hip-hop's fiber. You know what I mean? Motherfucker put on some fucking nice sneakers and all of a sudden he's a fucking star on stage and shit. And he lip-syncing his fucking words. It couldn't happen in a backyard party where I come from or a yard or barbecue somewhere where the DJ set up and plug the mic, Radio Shack mics on. We rocking like a motherfucker. Niggas walk away from you in the back backyard, nigga, you trash. You couldn't even keep the crowd around the DJ booth and shit. Yeah. But nowadays, it's about your clothes, what you got on, and all that little stupid shit, and then how much shit you can talk. You know what I mean?
So we as platforms or so-called, I'll say so-called journalistic platforms or blogs or, you know, all these different outlets, all these different streaming shows, these talk shows, these podcast shows, you feel like we perpetuate some of this farce.
Yeah.
I think everything that's negative gets promoted. Mm-hmm. Everything that, look, I'm telling you, anything I do positive, it never get promoted. I never get no compliments on anything that's good. But as soon as something bad happens to me, or especially with the 6ix9ine situation, I was everywhere.
Yeah.
I was everywhere.
What was the 6ix9ine? I didn't really.
It wasn't a situation. It was a misunderstanding. When I say misunderstanding, I think people were just using him to do their dirty work. But it's all good. We talked about it, and it's cool. I feel like
when you met him, what did you think? How did you assess it when you met him? When you actually came face to face with him, what did you see?
When I met him, I looked at him and said, this could be my little brother. He's a little kid. You know what I'm saying? And we got to treat these people like that. Because I say, just like with the XXX situation, he was an XXX. He was a troller. XXX cursed at Drake's mom or did whatever, posted Drake's mom on internet. Stuff like that. Everybody didn't want no parts of him. Now, when he died, everybody was like, oh, my gosh, he was the new Tupac. Oh, I wanted to work with him. Oh, he was great. He was a legend, a young legend of his time. But I'm like, dang, ain't nobody tell this man that when he was alive. Because when even I talk to you or I talk to anybody that's an OG in the game and they compliment me, I'm hype. I might not say it now, but when I leave, I be like, yeah, I'm doing something right. I might want to go right or left. But I just be like, you know what? Nah, I'm on the right path. I'm doing good. I'm working. I'm busy. Right? So why wait till somebody dies to do all of this? Like, even with Son. Son probably just need a little talking to.
Yeah.
He's a kid. When I was a kid, I was getting stabbed in the yard. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was breaking phones in jail when I was 20 years old. You know what I'm saying? I was telling the riot squad, come on. I ain't locking in. I was hard-headed. I took some lumps and bruises to understand, now, hold on, this is not what I want to do for the rest of my life. I'm not going back. You know what I'm saying? And just like what I said, don't wait till I die to tell me anything bad or good, man. Because I can't hear no Instagram texts or no tweets or no songs you made for me. You know what I'm saying? I just don't get it. But again, I learned the industry. The industry is a wave of a facade. Now, again, Bump, right? You also. The corporate world can mourn for all these individuals. We can mourn too. But we not pulling up to nobody's funeral site that we don't know. Like, come on. You what I'm pulling up to anybody, we ain't got no bond. You know, all right, cool. That's messed up. That was wrong, but keep it pushing.
You're going to keep living your life.
These dudes is pulling up to these people's house.
Because the cameras are there.
And recording it.
They're doing that because
the cameras. And pouring a little liquor out. We see that every day. From when you're from the hood. Every day. Word, what you call it? Got shot down the block. Oh, man, that boy was wild. That's crazy. And keep it moving. Now, for views, these people are recording murders, recording everything just for views. Everything. Like, me personally, I'm not taking no picture with, God forbid, anyone of my family die and posting it on the internet. I'm not doing that. Who wants to see, why would you want your family member to go out like that? Like, posting a picture of your family member dead in the bed for it to go around the ground. I mean, around the gram. I think everybody's doing it for attention, man. Everybody's reaping the benefits of this Instagram, and it's messed up. So you just gotta know what's real, know what's fake. And the crazy thing is, when they say he died, tell me you didn't think of it. Oh, that's fake.
For a second, people, yeah, you didn't even think it was real.
For like 3 days, I'm like, this ain't... Dang, he pulled the biggest stunt in the world.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking, because the gram got us so... Is this real? Like, you can really see something happen on the gram and see the person that happened to and be like...
Is that real?
Was that real? And like, yeah, nigga, I got a whole... My neck missing. Look. Because you don't believe. The trolls messed up the industry. Like, dangerously. It's not even about rap no more, like you said. Yeah. It's not about rap. You got to stand out.
See, let me say something to you, young fellas. What happens is you become great. You'll become great when you realize that the shit that you think you're good at is going to go on without you.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that. So as an MC, I still rock because I know that once I'm finished with this shit, the game going to still keep going.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to worry more about what I'm going to leave here for people to say when they mention my name and they dig up my catalog. They're going to say, oh, the nigga had bars at 51.
Yeah.
The nigga had bars.
Mm-hmm.
At 60, the nigga had bars. I guarantee you, if I live to be 90, I'm going to have bars.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what I do.
Yeah.
But the game going to go on without me. When people say, oh, this is a young man's game. No, it's an MC's game.
Yes.
If you dope, it's a rapper. It's a DJ's game. Mm-hmm. A dope DJ's game. It's a producer's game. That's who the game belongs to. So
Definitely. Don't
fall for the fuckery and the mindset that the corporate motherfuckers who had the money to simplify this shit did. You know what I mean?
I definitely won't fall for it.
Yeah, they figured out, yo, I know how to simplify that shit. I can't spin a record back six times like Flash said, and all I can't do. I just want to hit the fucking button.
Yeah.
I want to push beat match or BPM match or whatever the fuck they tell you to do. Now everybody's DJing. So then they can give $200,000, $300,000 to Paris Hilton for standing behind a set of fucking push button turntables and shit like that. But if you tell that broad, hey, listen, I know you do what you do. Take these two records, these two fucking needles right here, blow them shits off. DJs know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
It's not going to happen.
Yeah.
So just like the trolls on the internet, there's trolls that ain't on the internet.
Yeah, it's, you know, trolled. What I mean? People been trolling for years, though. But it now it's to the point where it's just crazy. People been lying about who they've been or who they are in the rap game for years.
You see, you should have been at the traditional radio station when we had to stand outside and wait for Red Alert to come out with and say, "Yo, Red, I got a new record. My name is Freddie Fox. I got a new record. Man, get that shit out my face. Show. I don't want to hear that shit."
Yeah.
And you had to earn their ears.
Yeah.
Motherfucker send me a link with 10 songs attached to it now, but I had to stand outside the radio station and at these other stations back in the days and wait for these motherfuckers to come downstairs in a car that I borrowed from my man's mom's and shit, me and him in the city where we supposed to be on the island. So the grind may be different, but the trolling ain't gonna never stop. But it's a different type of sucker shit that guys are doing now. It's a different breed of
sophisticated sucker.
Yeah, sophisticated
sucker shit.
And they telling you they doing sucker shit though.
Yeah. Yeah.
They telling you. I don't care.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm getting on.
By any means necessary. Yeah,
and that's what it is.
Hey man, I want to thank you for coming through this, man. I wanted to make this moment happen because I love you two dudes. All right. When I tell you I love you, I don't say that lightly.
Thank you, man. Okay? I love you too, man. Appreciate it.
And then I want people to actually support their music. Fox, you're gonna hang out with us a little longer.
Yeah, sure.
But Casanova got the Commissary Project that's out today. Pick it up. He got a couple bangers on there. He got Mozzie from the West Coast. He put the homie G Easy on that track too.
Mm-hmm.
What you want to hear off the project?
Red Dot.
Red Dot.
Yeah.
Snap Dog.
Yeah.
Who's that?
He from Detroit, man. I like him, man. I was in Detroit with him the other day, man. And he had me in the slums. I like the slums for some reason.
Uh-huh.
Just to go there and just see the hood. I don't want to go nowhere and just be in the good part. I want to see like where it started at, where stuff like it makes me feel attached, like I know there.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? I was like, I was on 8 Mile. I was on 7. Yeah, I was over there by the corner store, right?
Uh-huh.
You know that corner store? Like, I want to feel connected. And he made me feel connected, man. I appreciate him.
All right. That's what's up, man. Stay great, fam.
You already know. And I'm going to listen to your music
now.
Yeah,
please do, man.
I'm going to be stealing your quotes.
Yeah. I made them so you could do that.
All right. There it is. Play in the morning.
I'm not doing no more leg shots. Yo, I'm tight doing no more leg shots.